Well, welcome everyone to the 2021 Kentucky Forest Health Conference. It is a delight to have you joining us today over Zoom. For those of you who attended last year's conference, that was our first Kentucky Forest Health Conference. And while this year the format is a little different, we don't have as nice of a view maybe, I am delighted that we're able to continue this over Zoom and connect you to some fantastic speakers from around the country to talk about forest health issues that are impacting us right now or on the horizon, things to be thinking about for the future. So the agenda for today, I believe all of you have, but we're gonna start with forest health issues in Kentucky by Abe Nielsen and Alexander Blevins with the Kentucky Division of Forestry. We're then going to move on to Asian longhorn beetle updates by Dr. Philip Baldoff with the USDA APHIS. Then we will have a session on invasive plant management with presentations from Lori Chamberlain with the Virginia Department of Forestry about grazing down invasive plants, Dr. Kirsten Wickert with West Virginia Department of Agriculture about native fungal biocontrol of the invasive tree of heaven. And then from Jess Slade with the Office of Kentucky Nature Preserves, information on invasive plant management in sensitive areas, methods used for Short's goldenrod recovery. Then I will present on the Healthy Woods app, a new tool to help woodland owners assess the health of their woods. We will hear from Dr. Cliff Sadoff about understanding opportunities and limits of chemical control for emerald ash borer. We will have an update from Dr. Jared Westbrook with the American Chestnut Foundation, and we'll wrap it up with a survey and some conclusions. So I want to take a moment to just recognize all of our sponsors for this event, particularly the Kentucky Forest Health Task Force, the University of Kentucky, and the many different departments and cooperative extension individuals that have been involved in this. The Kentucky Division of Forestry for all of their support and leadership in this, as well as the Forest Health Research and Education Center and the Kentucky Invasive Plant Council. Also, just a recognition to our many speakers and moderators today. On top of those that I mentioned as our presenters, I want to recognize Joe Collins with the Kentucky Office of the State Entomologist and UK Entomology, as well as Carl Harper with the same organizations, and Renee Williams. I know you've been getting emails from her, and she is behind the scenes helping with everything that we're doing here today. So a big thank you to everyone involved in making this happen. And before we move on, a few important notes on this meeting. So in this meeting format, please use the question and answer function to ask questions of presenters. That will allow them to respond, and you can even kind of upvote people's questions if there's something that you're also curious about. We're using the webinar format of Zoom today instead of the meeting format, so it might look a little bit different, and that Q&A option is available. On the other hand, use chat if you have programmatic questions or having technology issues, or have some questions for me about that. I know that many of you are seeking CEUs for today, and if you are, there will be a survey at the end that you need to complete to get those. It will have all the information that we need to submit those to the right organizations. And we will ask for which CEUs you're seeking. We are providing credits for Kentucky Pesticide Applicators, Society of American Foresters, and Kentucky Board of Landscape Architects. And then we'll ask you for some information related to that, like your license number. If you have any questions about that, please let me know, and I can connect you to those answers. So without further ado, I want to turn it over to Carl Harper, who will be introducing our first speakers of the day.